And with us now is Dr. David Bendor. He is a psychologist, at the Institute of Living. And Dr. Bendor, thanks for being with us. That was a traumatic event that we watched unfold on television, and Now we're watching these school massacres unfolding most recently in Florida, sadly. What is the impact it's having on people?
Well, and that's a great question because, first, thank you for having me. You know, my real concern with this kind of coverage is the impact it's having on two groups. One is the general public, your viewers, you know, people throughout the country. And then I'm also concerned about the impact it's having on the more vulnerable, the vulnerable, I'm speaking psychiatrically speaking, but the vulnerable population. So it's clearly having an effect. This is not just me theorizing. I meet people in my practice and at the hospital, and I can see and hear from them the effect it's having on each of them.
When you say vulnerable, do you also mean those who potentially could commit a crime?
You know, that's really not what I'm thinking when I say that. I'm thinking about the people who are impacted in various ways.
Okay.
I'm thinking of the people who are struggling with depression, struggling with anxiety. There are times when we have folks who are even more disturbed, and it does have a different kind of impact on them. It kind of resonates differently than it may on a quietly depressed or anxious person.
And obviously, you know, the advice to any parent is make sure your children are, you know, watching with you or explaining what's going on, correct?
Yeah, I definitely encourage parents to be very careful whenever any of these kind of events happen. Depending on the age, I either want the kids to be as kept away as much as possible. If they're a little bit older, they probably are going to want to watch. They're going to hear it on the buses. They're going to hear it in schools. They might overhear teachers talking. And then, as you said, correct, you want a culture in the household where the kids know they can ask their parents anything, watch, raise any concerns they might have.
When a potential criminal mind does watch this kind of coverage, can that sway them
to
do something sinister?
Yeah, and that's a concern, and it's something that, you know, I've talked about since Columbine, Colorado. Sandy Hook, of course. You know, there are a few, and I've met some in psychiatric facilities who have referenced past shootings as somehow inspirational to them. You know, these folks are struggling mightily in various ways, and they're feeling very slighted, very marginalized by society, if you will. Their thinking is not sound, but they find something that really resonates with them with all this attention given to a similarly disturbed person.
Is there a concern that we can all become desensitized because it's on TV so frequently?
You know, it's funny you say that. Earlier in the week, I worked with a very bright young lady, a high schooler, and, you know, being that she's a high schooler, I wanted to know how this is affecting her, of course, as I've asked people of all ages. And she was saying it's amazing. She said, when these were first being reported, she didn't...
That's your new baby, by the way. Congratulations.
Is that really?
That's okay.
Okay. But she was saying when these were first reported, she was really having trouble making sense of. She was terrified. Her friends were terrified. She has said that over time, though, it hasn't resonated in the same way. And she fears she is being somewhat desensitized. In a way, though, it's comforting for her. Yeah, I do fear that people are desensitized when they're bombarded with this kind of coverage.
You know, I always enjoy having you on because you always have some great advice about, you know, what to do and what to tell your kids and so forth. So if people have a problem, who should they call?
If people have problems in terms of what they're hearing, they should reach out to their, if they're young enough, they should first go to their parents or school nurses. And then those hopefully, if there's greater concern beyond that, they should reach out to a licensed mental health professional.
And they'll refer you up the chain. Dr. David Bendor from the Institute of Living. We thank you so much. Congrats on the new baby, by the way.
Thank you.
She sounds very healthy.
Okay.
Thanks for watching Face the State on this Sunday morning. Our next news is tonight with Kevin Hogan. I'll see you back here tomorrow.